Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. In today's session, we are going to learn how we can create nested flows using Power Automate. So when I say nested flow, that means like I would be having a couple of parent flow and that would be calling child flow in turn. And the common logic I would be writing in child flow. So consider a scenario where I want to create the MS Planet task in multiple cases. For example, if I receive email from my manager saying that new tasks has been created, then it should trigger and create a MS Planet task for me. And even as well, when I receive a message within my channel that stating that task is assigned to that person, so it should also create the Planet task. And as well as if something some trigger happen in SharePoint task list, then it should create the same MS task. So in short, like we are having three trigger conditions, and the same trigger conditions want to do the same logic of code. In that case, we'll be creating these three parent flows and one child flow, which would be having the logic or the actions to create the Planet task. So this is how we are going to create the nested flows. So I'm jumping to the MS the flow.microsoft.com so that I can show you the entire demo. So I'm here. So for creating that parent and child flow, I'll be going to solutions. And under solution, I'll be creating one solution naming create a planner task and choosing the publisher as CDS publisher and then just creating it. So this flow should be created somewhere, this solution. And if I click on this create planet task, it will redirect me to this solution pane. Where now I can create flow. So I'll start creating with child flow because my entire logic would be in child. And then afterwards I'll create parent flow. So when the child flow should get called. So because this child flow has to be called from parent flow. So I'll use the trigger as when and HTTP. Right. So I got this. Now I'll use the sample payload to generate the schema for it. So what I'll write is just simply I'll say the title for task. So I will just say title new task, and I'll have the owner for this task. So I'll just say owner, and I can specify the sample value so that it can generate the actual schema for me. All right, so I'm just doing done. So it created that schema for me from my sample, which I actually just wrote in. And now in the next step, I'll be doing the actual operation. So when I say actual operation, I'll use create a planner task. So it will create a planner task for me. And under this, I'll specify which planner group I would like to bind that. So it will be under my project task. So as I already opened it, so there's a group which I created recently. So and the new task would be created under this group and buckets. So I'm choosing that setting, plan ID, and choosing that my project task. In title, I'll bind up that with whatever I received from this HTTP request. I'm just binding that title, and under the bucket ID and everything, I'm leaving as a blank. Due date I can also receive as in parameter from this, but right now I'm just leaving that. And under the assign to user, I'm just binding that to owner, and which is an email ID. So that's how we can create the child flow. But because this flow has to be called from the parent flow, we have to have the responded back. So I'll use respond to a power app or flow so that I can respond the variable back to my recalling flow. I'm just clicking that add. I'm saying yes or no. I can just use some variable task created and passing that as yes. So because my task is created. So now I am good with my child flow. I just need to rename it child flow create task so that I can call this while creating my parent flow. my child flow is done. Now I'll again back go back to my solution to create a new flow, which would be the parent flow. And under this, I'll again choose flow, and this time I'll choose the trigger as when email arrives. So when an email arrives, then what it should do, it should call my child flow if the email subject is whatever I would be passing in the filter. So whenever the person, you can pass it on, like you can say, if the email is going to arrive to this and is from your manager possibly, but right now because I'm the only person over here, so I'm choosing my name, then it should check for the subject filter as well. Let's say new task or new project task. So whenever it arrives with this subject name, then it should call my child flow. I can simply choose an action. I can simply say run a child. So I'll find it over here, run a child flow. So that means this flow would be in turn calling the flow which I have created just now. So it's saying child flow. So I'm calling that child flow, and I'm passing the title as title of my email or subject of my email, and the owner would be the to field. Okay. So whenever an email arrives in my inbox with the subject filter, then it should run my child flow to create the MS Planet task. So I'm just saving this one, and I'm renaming that as parent flow as well. Parent flow for email. The same kind of flow that with a different trigger condition we are creating for MS Teams as well. Whenever a message is posted in MS Teams, then it should again call the run a child flow. So I'm just going back to my solution. So I have these two flows right now. So my parent flow is for email, then my parent flow would be for MS Teams, my parent flow would be for SharePoint list. So all will call the same child flow to do the entire logic. So possibly this child flow may have the complex logic of creating tasks and then sending emails, and as well as like checking the approval flows, whether like if that is task is approved by some reviewers, then only that task should be created, otherwise it should not. So those kind of like logic you can have embedded in the child flow. So in long story short is, I mean, we are able to call the parent flow from child flow from parent flow over here. So now I am going to do the testing, and for testing I'll just go to my mailbox and I'll create a new mail, and this would be for me only, and in subject I'll say new project task, and when I say send, it should trigger out my, I'll just go to my parent flow and check whether my flow is running or not. So it ran, and it must have called my child flow, and right now my child flow should also be running. So I just go back and see the status. Okay, so my child flow is also running and is ran successfully. That means I should have one task under my planner. So now you can see I have that task under my MS planner. So this way we have called one parent flow and which in turn called a child flow to create this task. In the same way, I can go to my solution and create a new flow, and that flow would be triggering when message is received under my Teams and a new channel message is added. So you can simply choose that and choose out your the Teams, and you can choose out the channel, and the same way you can call or run a child flow, and under this you can specify the title and owner based on the message. So for message you can simply say message body content and owner as message user emails. message from user, not this one. User ID. So this is how you can have it in place, and whenever somebody is posting the message under your Teams, then it would again call the same child flow and create a planned task for you. So in short, I am trying to make you understand that we can have the multiple trigger conditions, multiple parent flow, and the complex logic can be taken care within a child flow. So there could be various scenarios you would like to have this in place with the nested flows. So possibly it could be beneficial for you for your ongoing projects or for the business process flows you want to build. So if you like my video, please do subscribe and drop a thumbs up. Thank you.